A lot of modern action cameras are capable of recording images or videos on an insanely beautiful quality. But most of them have a wide-angle lens and this will give distortion or the fisheye effect. If you want to remove this look from your footage, then this is the right tutorial for you. In this video, I'm going to show you how to apply lens correction and remove the fisheye look. We're going to use Photoshop to correct the photos and we'll use Premiere Pro to fix the videos. You can find timestamps for both parts on screen now and also in the video description. On most recent action cams, like the GoPro Hero 10 for example, you will find the option to shoot in linear mode. This mode eliminates the distortion or fisheye effect in camera. This might be a great option if you don't want to fix this in post. But keep in mind that the RAW option is not available in GoPro cameras if you shoot photos in this mode. Okay, now before I move over to Photoshop, first a quick shout out to Envato Elements for sponsoring this video. If you want to improve your video editing projects and make them look more professional, then definitely check out Envato Elements. They offer thousands of high quality video editing templates for apps like Premiere Pro and After Effects. Besides video editing templates, they also offer stock videos, music and sound effects, fonts and much more. And this is all included in one single subscription. And that's why I think that Envato Elements is a must-have for every content creator. If you want to give them a try, then please use my temporary discount code that you can find in the video description. This way you can try them a month for a couple of dollars. Now it's time to show you how to remove the fisheye effect from photos. In this folder I've got a couple of photos that I captured on a GoPro Hero 10 Black. And as you can see, I've got both the RAW, GPR file and also the JPEG file. I can now drag this RAW file over to Photoshop and this will open up Camera RAW in a new window. In here you could tweak the colors of your photo, but also apply lens correction. And we can do this in the Optics tab. In here we need to enable Use Profile Correction. And because Photoshop recognized this as a GoPro Hero 10 file, it instantly fixed the fisheye effect for me. If Photoshop does not recognize your camera, then you can also manually select your camera profile here. And in case your camera is not listed, then you can also use the distortion slider here at the bottom to correct your footage. And if you're done with correcting the distortion, you can click on this open button here at the bottom. This will open up the photo in Photoshop, where you can do more adjustments and then later on save this in any desired format, like JPEG for example. Speaking about JPEG, if you only have the JPEG file, so no RAW files, you can do the same inside Photoshop, but first you need to adjust some settings. First you need to go to Edit, then Preferences, and then select File Handling. And then you need to click on this Camera RAW Preferences button here. And then finally, at JPEG and TIFF Handling, select Automatically Open All Supported JPEGs. With this option selected, Photoshop will also open up Camera RAW if you import a JPEG file. So if I now drag one of the GoPro JPEG files over to Photoshop, it will open up Camera RAW. And as you can see, in here we can do the same adjustments as we did to the RAW file. And in this case, it also recognized that it's coming from a GoPro Hero 10. So in this case, it's all a matter of one single checkbox to fix the fisheye effect in Photoshop. Next, I'm going to show you how to fix lens distortion on your videos inside Adobe Premiere Pro. Inside Premiere, I've already got this clip ready on the timeline. And to fix this lens distortion, we need to add an effect. So we'll move over to the Effects panel. And if I open up the preset section, you can see that Premiere includes a lot of lens distortion presets for DJI and GoPro cameras. The video on the timeline is from a GoPro Hero 10 Black, so I will try one of the presets from the Hero 3 Plus folder. I will use the 4K wide preset and apply this to the video. Sometimes these presets are a perfect match, but as you can see here, this time it is not. Luckily, we can adjust these presets of the lens distortion effect inside the Effect Controls panel. And in this case, we just need to play around with the curvature slider to get the look that we want. If I now turn the effect on and off, you can see the difference. And you can also see the part of the image that we had to sacrifice to do this lens distortion correction. To be clear, you don't have to start with the presets, you can also directly apply the lens distortion effect to your video. And I've already shown you the curvature control, but there are a couple more controls that you can use to correct your footage, like the decentering and prism controls. With these finer manual controls, you should be able to correct most of the lens distortion in your videos. And that's it for this short Photoshop and Premiere Pro tutorial. I hope that this one helped you to improve your editing, and if it did, then please like the video or leave a comment below. I would really appreciate that. And finally, as always, thanks a lot for watching and I wish you all a wonderful day.